Hi students, welcome to our YouTube channel Digital Classes. You know, I am K. Saidulu, SA English, JPSS Ravinathala, Bonkal Mandal. So it's very clear. For more details in English, if you want to learn even spoken English, if you want to learn some songs and poems, better to subscribe to my channel. My channel name is Karlapudi Saidulu or Saidulu Karlapudi. Okay. Now let us go to our class, our lesson, our objectives of today, what we are going to learn. My dear students, you will be able to read and understand the lesson. The second one is, you will be able to answer some simple questions. You will be able to use the language in your own sentences. You will be able to prepare a poster at the end of our lesson. Okay, let us go to another slide. Here we are going to read individually. The individual reading takes, when you are reading the paragraph, take a pen or pencil, don't forget about it. When you understand a sentence, put a tick mark. When you don't understand the sentence, put a question mark. When you see a sentence which you like most, put a star mark. This is what we know already. Let us go to our paragraph. Now let us read this one. I don't know anything for certain. What sex was the snake? Was it male or female? So like this we were discussing about this paragraph. Just let me drag my photo to the down so that we can just go to our reading. I don't know anything for certain. What sex was the snake? Was it male or female? I will never know, for the snake unwound itself from my arm and slowly slithered into my lap. From there it crept on to the table and moved towards the mirror. Perhaps it wanted to enjoy its reflection at a closer quarters. Now let us have some understanding over this paragraph. I don't know anything for certain. Certain means confirm, sure, pakka. I don't know. You just find the difference between these two terms. I did not know is explaining about the past. I don't know is explaining about the present situation. Do you know Telugu? If anyone asks, our answer is very clear. I don't know. Do you know Malayalam? I don't know. Did you play? I did not play. Did you know anything? I did not know. So now you can easily understand the sentence. What sex was the snake? Was it a male or female? So how many genders are there in our society? You are right. Masculine gender, feminine gender. Is it true or is there any other sex? Yes, male, female, and also neutral gender. Masculine gender, feminine gender, and also neutral gender. Now, the question came to this man. Who is this man? This man is a doctor. What type of a doctor he is? You're right, he is a homeopath. So he got the doubt, what sex was the snake, was it a male or female? I will never know, not only now, not only in the past, but also I will never know, for the snake unwound itself from my arm and slowly slithered into my lap. Now you can easily understand the paragraph, just wound, unwound. Wound means, yes, you are right, circling, or we can say coiling round his hand. Now the snake is unwounding. Now you can easily understand. It is coming down itself from my arm and slowly came into my lap. Lap means, you know, vadi in Telugu we call mother's lap, thalli vadi. From there it crept on to the table and moved towards the mirror. Where did it move? Yes, it moved towards the mirror. Where are you going? Towards the class. Okay. Do you understand? Towards means atu vaipuga. Perhaps it wanted to enjoy its reflection at closer quarters. We don't know. Maybe it might be going to enjoy on seeing its reflection. Maybe at a closer quarters, going close and close. I was no merry image cut in a granite. Now you can easily understand. He was a stone. He was an image. He was a statue. He was nothing but, yes, you are right. He was a granite stone. Granite. Yes, you will use granite stones in your houses. I was suddenly a man of flesh and blood. Now he came to, yes, like a human being, flesh and blood. Flesh means mamsamu, blood means you are clear. Now I have a question for you. What is the opposite word of suddenly? Answer my question, my dear students. Suddenly. You are right. Gradually. The opposite word of suddenly is gradually. Sudden. Okay. Sudden death. Suddenly. The other form of sudden. Suddenly. Still holding my breath, I got up from the chair. Chair. Look at the pronunciation. Chair. I quietly went out through the door into the veranda. From there, I leaped into the yard and ran for all I was worth. Now we look at this man. He is running now. When is he running? Only when the snake slithered into his lap and just unwounded and then just came down. And it went to the mirror. Then only just he started running. Pow! Look at the word pow. It is an exclamation mark. We will know the meanings of these words. Let us see the meanings of these words. Okay. Shall we know? Okay. Let us see the meanings of the words. Shall we see the meanings? Okay, dear students. Let us see. Later we will see otherwise. Pow! Each of us heaved a sigh of relief. All of us lit BDs. What does it mean, BDs? Now go for the meaning. Pow. A short reaction of relief. Heaved. Lift with a great effort. Will. A legal document. Reedy. High and thin in tone of voice or sound. Sprinter. An athlete who races for short distances. Smeared. Spread over something. Okay. Now let us go again to the paragraph. Pow, each of us heaved a sigh of relief. All of us lit BDs. Somebody asked, "Doctor, is your wife very fat?" No, the doctor said. What did the doctor say? No. God willed otherwise. My life companion is a thin, reedy person with the gift of a sprinter. Now his imagination, his ideology entirely changed. See, human beings always change. One day, one of my friends is telling, "Prapanchamlo edi nilabadadu, marpu matrame permanent." So the change only stands forever. That is what one of my friends said. So the God willed otherwise. Otherwise means in a different way. God's will is different. My will, God's will. Man proposes, God disposes. That is what we know for a long time. God willed otherwise. God's will was in other way. God wrote in other words, in other way. My life companion is a thick, the opposite word of thin is thick. Thin, reedy person with the gift of a sprinter. Yes, the person who can participate in short running races with a high amount of speed, high speed, having pace in their running. Someone else asked, "Doctor, when you ran, did the snake follow you?" What a silly question. The doctor replied, I ran until I reached my friend's house. He was running. Now let us complete the paragraph. Immediately I smeared oil all over myself and took a bath. I changed into fresh clothes. The next morning at about 8:30, I took my friend and one or two others to my room to move my things from there. But we found we had a little to carry. Some thief had removed most of my things. The room had been cleared out, but not really. The thief had left behind one thing as a final insult. So now, my dear students, my dear friends, let us understand this situation. Immediately, he got some bad smell on his body, so he took a bath. So, bathing. I changed into fresh clothes. Look at the sentence. I changed into fresh clothes. Into. The next morning at about 8:30, Actually, yes, 8:30 here. I took my friend and one or two others to my room to move my things from there. What could be there with him? We saw in the first picture. We saw also in the second picture what were the things with him. But we found we had little to carry. When they went in, they found only few things. What could have happened? Yes, some thief had removed most of my things. Most of my things means mostly nearly 99% of his things were taken away, were removed. Yes, were looted. Now I have a question. Can you name some other names for the thief? Thief. You are right. Robber. Then pickpocketer. Loot. Yes, there are so many words for a thief. We will know all these things later on. The room had been cleaned out, but not really. But not really cleaned out, but not really taken away by the thief everything. But the thief had left one thing. What is that one thing? Yes, that one thing is nothing but a final insult for that man. Now, on seeing the picture, you can easily understand what the thief could have left. What was that? I asked. The person who had been listening to this narration, this story, he was very eager to know what was there. He asked, "What was that?" Doctor said, "My vest, the dirty one." The fellow had such a sense of cleanliness. Look at the way of expressing, look at the way of the plot here in this story. So this is called the narrative system of the system of narrating. The rascal could have taken it and used it after washing it with a soap or water. Now this man is really disgusted, was in a disgust because, yes, he took away everything except one thing, that is a dirty undergarment which he wears on the top of his body like a vest. The rascal, now I have a question for you. Now, let us see, a group of rascals is called mob, yes or no? A group of soldiers is called?
Army,
you're right. Okay, a group of monkeys is called? Troop, you're right. A group of musical instrument players is called?
Musicians.
Come on, tell me, band, yes, you will see in marriages, band. Okay, like that we will see a collection of stories, anthology, like that we will know. Okay, one word substitutes we will know. A group of rascals is called? Yes, mob. Did you see the snake the next day, the doctor? The doctor laughed. I have never seen it since. It was a snake which was taken with its own beauty. I did not see that snake anymore. The snake is really a wonderful one, a beautiful one. So, this is a narration we should know. Let us go to another slide and we will see what we have to do. Answer the following questions, my dear students. The doctor heard the sound coming from the above three times. What was that? Oh, you are exactly right. Snake sound. Yes, the snake's hissing sound. The snake's hissing sound, even the sound of a rat's. Why did the doctor sit like a stone? Doctor sat like a stone because this is the way you have to start the answer. The doctor sat like a stone. Sat because did sit. Why did the doctor sit like a stone? The doctor sat like a stone because the snake fell on his shoulder. Yes or no? Okay, repeat after me. The doctor sat like a stone because the snake fell on his shoulder. You're right. Okay, now let us go to third question. What made the doctor forget his fears and have a sense of relief? The doctor forgot his fears and he got a sense of relief because the snake went away or slithered down and fell into lap and ran away. Did the snake admire its beauty? Yes or no? Pick the lines from the passage in support of your answer. Okay? After going home, please open your textbook, answer all these questions so that you will be able to have what we can say reading comprehension questions. You will be able to write so many answers. Why did the doctor want to marry a doctor? What kind of a woman doctor who would he like to marry? This question we got the answer. Doctor wanted to marry another doctor. The doctor should be, how should be the doctor? In the beginning, the doctor should be a fat one, and the doctor should be, the female doctor should be a rich one, a fat one, and also a beautiful one. Yes or no? Yes. In those days, I was great admirer of beauty. Do you think looks are more important than skills and behavior? Why? Quite natural. Looks are more important nowadays also. They are not bothering about behavior. They are not bothering about the character. They are not bothering about the conduct. Behavior? Yes. Conduct? And also? Yes, you are right. So, those three are the words which we can just use other than this word. Conduct, behavior, and also? Yes. What did the doctor think about the snake when it looked into the mirror? Who knows? Doctor might have thought that a snake was looking into the mirror and it was admiring its beauty. Why did the doctor run to his friend's house? Did the snake want to harm the doctor? Or why not? It's very clear. Doctor was terrified. Doctor was in fear. Doctor was really afraid of snakes. Now, answer my question. Are you afraid of anything? Yes, I am afraid of snakes. I am afraid of English sir. I am afraid of so and so. I am afraid of snakes. Okay, the doctor is afraid of snake. So, as soon as the snake slithered down, he ran to his friend's house. Okay, now let us go to a poster. Look at this poster. Look it for 2 or 3 minutes. Then you can easily understand the poster. Okay, while looking at the picture, try to have your words when I ask you. Who issued the poster? Come on, read the poster. Yes, you are right. The Hyderabad Laughing Club issued the poster. Issued means gave. Who gave the poster? What is the purpose of the poster? Purpose means, tell me my dear friends, purpose, aim, yes you are right, goal, yes, okay, what is the purpose of the poster? The poster's purpose is, is welcoming the write-ups. The purpose of the poster is to encourage humor. Okay, what is the deadline? What is this deadline? Deadline means, my dear friends, tell me, deadline. Last date. You're right. Deadline means last date. Deadline for entries. Look at in this color. So, there it is. You can see July 22nd, 27th. Okay. So, you want to see? Yes, you see here. Here is a deadline. Yes, this one is deadline. Okay. What are the other details highlighted? Come on, tell me. Here, look at this picture. It is highlighted, this picture. How is the picture? The picture is expressing humor. And what are the things highlighted? The Raja Babu Prize. And what are the highlighted things? There, they are writing. Yes, they are welcoming write-ups in three languages. Telugu, Urdu and English. They are also giving a wonderful prize money for the award. What is the prize money? 5,000 rupees each award carries. And the role of, look at the title of this poster. Yes, the role of the comedy in the human life. Okay, now we can just go for next question. Next question, here is. Next question. Okay, next question. What are the other details highlighted? What should be highlighted in the poster? Who are the targeted audience? Now answer these questions. What should be highlighted in the poster actually? Yes. whatever has to be highlighted has been highlighted. Now, who are the targeted audience? It is also mentioned there. Now, what are the elements means? Now, just look at this one. I would just tell you something. Look at this one. What are the elements of the poster? Look at this one. Look at this one. Elements effective poster. Color, size, layout, font size, language, etc. Okay. Once again, color, size, layout, font size, and language. Okay, my dear friends, do you understand? Now, let us go to some other questions like this. Let us see one more question. Now, prepare a poster using the information given below by arranging it in an order. How is the order given? Theme. Highlights, information, theme. What is the theme? Humor. Occasion, the laughter day. Category, stories, songs, poems, essays, articles, and cartoons. Award, Best Comic Writer Award. What is award? Best Comic Writer Award. What is the prize amount? Oh, 10,000 rupees. Contact number? Here is a contact number given. What is the deadline? Deadline is 9th August, issued by ABC Laughing Club, ZPSS Ravinathala, Bonakal. Target audience, writers, journalists, poets, essayists, cartoonists. If you want to know all these details, you just go to your textbook, page number 14. There you will see all these things. Okay, my dear students, do you understand? Okay, now let us go to next page. Use the linkers given in the box to complete the story. It is also available in our textbook. Use the linkers given in the box to complete the story. A linker, what is the other word here? Yes, the linker may be used more than once. Oka linker ni mano 2 or 3 times kuda use chesukochata. Let us read. A young doctor lived in a village. The doctor told his friends, my dear students, what I want to tell you is, look at these words here: as, if, but, who, when, which, so, while. All these are, what are they? All these are linking words. Now, what is a linking word? What does it mean, linker? Linker is nothing but conjunction. What is a conjunction? Yes, to join two sentences or two words, we use conjunction. For example, tell me and, but, so, if, unless. Here are some: as, if, but, who, when, which, so, while. These are the words you have to substitute in the blanks. Look at the blank. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 blanks are given. It is also available in your textbook. It is better you just go to your textbook and do all these things in your textbook, and also write down all these things in your notebook. Don't forget to write your handwriting neatly. Okay. Now, let us read. A young doctor lived in a village. The doctor told his friends an interesting story about himself and cobra. It was a hot summer night. There was a blank. You can just fill with one. He opened the door. He heard a sound. There is a one more blank. Was well known to him. Who was well known to him? Somebody was well known to him. Who might be that one? Yes. What is that one? Sound. He and rats shared the room. There was no electricity in the house. He took out a box of matches and lit a kerosene lamp. There was a blank before that one. He took off his clothes and lay down. There is a one more blank. He could not sleep. He got up from the bed and started reading a storybook. Near the table, there was a mirror. What was that? Tempted him to look into at himself. What is that? Mirror. You can use, when it is representing a person, you can use who. Do you understand? This is the man who is arrested. Who killed that man? Who means ever. It is also representing yes, he, she, all these things. When is representing time. Which is representing yes, you are right, for things, for snakes, for some other animals, like that. If you know the meaning. If means the opposite word of unless. The opposite word of unless is if. If means okavela aite. Unless aite, okavela kanatlaite. As, while, when also represent the past tense. As I was opening the door, as I was coming into the house, as I was opening the door, the telephone was ringing. While I was opening the door, the telephone was ringing. While I was locking the door, a sound came from inside. While, when, as, most of the times are used in a past tense. Do you understand? Now you can easily understand. So, you can fill all these words. As, if, but, who, when, which, so, while. Let us go to next one. Okay. Now, look at this one. Here is a grammar part for us. Grammar part for us. Okay. Shall we go and see the grammar part now? Okay. Now, just I drag my photo down here. Let us see here. We found. We had little to carry. Some thief had removed most of my things. In the above two sentences, the first one is in the simple past, found, had, and the second is in the past perfect tense, had removed. As you can see, the action which occurred earlier is expressed in the past perfect tense, whereas the action which occurred later is expressed in the simple past tense. Here are a few more examples for you. Sujata had arrived at the station before the train came. Now, my dear friends, the train came. Before that, something had happened. Sujata had arrived at the station. So, the first action is very clear. Sujata had arrived. Before that, the train came is now happened in the past. But before that, just before that, something happened that is used as perfect tense. Now, I have a sentence for you. She has done her homework just now. Okay? He has killed that snake. I haven't seen the movie. All these are present perfect tense. Past perfect tense are here. I had brushed my teeth. Sujata had arrived. The train had left. The train had left the station before I went. Before I went, what happened? The train had left the station. Now you can easily understand. Now let us go to the second sentence. The doctor arrived after the patient had died. Now third sentence. I bought the ticket as soon as I boarded the bus. When two actions occur nearly simultaneously in the past, both are expressed in the past. No problem. Now combine the following pairs of sentences using the past perfect and the simple past. Will you? Okay. Now first, let us read what are the sentences are given. The first one has been done for you. It is, I brushed my teeth, I took the breakfast. After I had brushed my teeth, I took my breakfast. Or you can write like that. I had brushed my teeth before I took my breakfast. Forget about all these things. She started to go to the market. It rained heavily. Look at these two sentences and also look at one more sentence here. We completed his homework. He went to bed. He completed. He went. I finished. My father came. I fell. I met. I locked. I went. All these are explaining the simple past tense. In the sense, completed actions. My dear friends, it is a right opportunity for you to say or to write few more past actions. You might have read in your 7th class textbook page number 240 and 241 all these, yes, present, past participle, verb 3 forms. For example, go, went, gone, complete, completed, completed. There only you will see what? Irregular verbs. Please once again go through all those irregular verbs, read them, then you can easily write some few sentences into past tense. Now your homework is very clear. Write at least a few of sentences from our textbook or from your life, and also use if action takes place now, that is present. If the action place before that one, that is present perfect tense. But here it is different. Look at this one. Action took place in the past, and the action took place before that one, that is called past perfect. For example, here is given. One more time, let us read. Look at this one. I brushed my teeth. I took my breakfast. I had brushed my teeth before I took the breakfast. Do you understand? Will you write few more sentences? Okay. Okay, my dear friends. Let us go to some phrasal verbs from our textbook. Here are nearly 10 phrasal verbs which I just gave meanings. Took out, take out, set up, take off, lie down, take time off, look into, look at, get up, change into, leave behind. All these are phrasal verbs. Phrasal verbs are nothing but two words, maybe one verb and a preposition will become one and will give another meaning. For example, backup. Backup is nothing but support. Okay, take out. Take out, there is a meaning given. Set up, I have given the meaning. All these things are also available in our textbook. Get up. Get up to wake up. Look at, to have a look at something. Sixth one, look into, to observe keenly. Look after, to take care of. It's not here. Look after, to take care of. Okay. So, look for. Look for means wait. So, all these are the words which we will get. So, for the next class, if there is any time, so you may just see all these words. If you want to know all these phrasal verbs and also remaining lessons in our 9th class textbook, please go to my channel. Saidulu Karlapudi, you visit my channel, look at most of the videos in my channel, and also you may subscribe to my channel. You will see more and more videos upcoming, even for 9th class, grammar, spoken English, motivational classes, all these things. Thank you for this opportunity. Bye. Let us meet in the next class.